Namaste. Revered Mr. Gopal Srinivasan, Prasanna, and dear friends. It seems a man rushes to the 15th floor and says, Sharma, Sharma, your daughter ran away. Rushes to the 15th floor and says, Sharma, Sharma, your daughter has been eloped, ran away. This man gets so frustrated, so despondent, he jumps from the 15th floor to commit suicide because he's a very orthodox man. Right? And his daughter has eloped. And as his body was coming to the 10th floor, he realizes he is not married. So how can he have a daughter? He's not married. How can he have a daughter? And as his body was coming to the 8th floor, he realizes he has not got a daughter. Without getting married also, you can have a daughter, no? So he has not got a daughter. And as his body was coming to the 4th floor, he realizes he is not Sharma. His name was Varma. Friends, now tell me, when this man was told, Sharma, your daughter ran away, what did he do? Immediately, he jumps onto the 15th floor. Now, was this an action or a reaction? Reaction. In Sanskrit, we say, it is not a kriya, it is a pratikriya. It is not a kriya, it is a pratikriya. And throughout the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna tells us to act, convert your karma into an yoga, not to react, not pratikriya. And therefore the first thing, if you want to put 101%, right, of commitment for excellence, you have to learn to do kriya and not pratikriya. Learn to respond and not be mechanical in life there. So just digest this example, friends. When he said, hey, Sharma, your daughter ran away, he reacted, and technically in yoga, we say this is not operating from a magnetic center, it was operating from a mechanical center. He was mechanical, isn't it? Right? When he says Sharma, daughter away, he was mechanical. Mechanical center, when you start operating, the quality of your life is going to be in the low ebb. Yoga tells us operating from a mechanical center is being like a machine, and you and I are not a machine. We are a conscious human being, and therefore yoga tells us, can you learn to operate from a magnetic center? When you operate from a magnetic center, then you respond to life and not react. So in the simple mudra called Chin Mudra, this finger represents Jivatma, the lower self, the lower energies, where we are reacting with like, dislike, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsalya, we says. Now this is called mechanical center. To desanskritize to this group there, it is called mechanical, technically it is called as Jivatma. But when you start operating from your higher energies of life, when you want to put 101% for your commitment for excellence, when you are operating, you are responding, and for that to happen, you have to operate from a magnetic center, not a mechanical center. You have to operate from a magnetic center. When you operate from, that is called in Sanskrit as Paramatma. So this is Jivatma, this is Paramatma, and you do a mudra called Chin Mudra, means can your lower energies surrender to the higher energies. When your lower energies surrender to your higher energies, your life is going to be Purnamadav, Purnamidam, Purnath, Purnamudachyate, means your life is going to be complete, full and total. Now what these three fingers mean, we'll see. And therefore, friends, the greatest choice for us to excellence, the greatest choice for us for excellence is, are we operating from lower energies or higher energies? Simple word, right? Are you operating mechanically? All of you. Good evening. Now tell me, why do we say good evening? Or namaste? Why do you say good evening? Why? For two reasons. If the evening is good, let us recognize it, it's good. Let us validate it, it's good. The evening is beautiful, no? Beautiful ambience, what a beautiful knowledge pravaha you're going through right now. So therefore, the evening is good. Let us recognize and validate it. And therefore, we say good evening to recognize it. And if the evening is not good, let us make it good. And therefore, we say good evening, isn't it? When you say namaste, means you and I in the space of love are one. See this oneness. See the God in you, see the God in me, see this. Right? So therefore, how many of you said good evening with this meaning? Raise your hand. Most of us says good evening, good evening. Namaste, namaste. One mosquito is crushed in in between. So therefore, you see, this is operating from a mechanical center. This is operating like a machine, but God has made you and I not as a machine, as a magnetic, conscious human being. And therefore, the greatest challenge for excellence is, can you really be conscious? Now, whatever is taught, even in this 1 hour, the concept is very simple. But it is going to become difficult for us to practice it. Any concept, if you see, it's simple. It is going to be difficult for us to practice because there's so much like a machine we operate. I'll do a small process. All of you do this. Keep your left hand, all of you. Keep your left hand like this. Just to convey this concept through a simple, through a game. Go up and down. Come on, all of you. Up and down. Vertical, go up and down. Please continue doing that. Continue doing that. Now, without stopping this left hand going up and down, take your right hand, keep it like this. Keep your left hand going up and down. Take your right hand like this. Go forward and back. Forward and back. Just let this go up and down. Not go up and down, forward and back. Forward and back. Continue. You are doing like this. Some of you are doing butterfly. Now, you see, the concept was so simple. Don't stop. Come on. Up and down. Up and down, take other, forward and back. Together. I hardly see anybody doing that. No, the concept is so simple and it's difficult. You practice this for about a few days and you'll get it. Now tell me, all of you are very brilliant senior executives here. Why is that? You may be engineers, you may be so many things. Why is that the concept is so simple, going up and down, forward and back? Why is it becoming difficult? Why? You know, your body is used to a certain mechanical rhythm. And when a new rhythm is given to you, you find it very difficult. Because the body mechanically operates in one dimension. And if you practice, therefore in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagena cha grihyate. It is constant practice, it will happen. So therefore it is a simple process. Your body is used to a certain rhythm. A new rhythm is given to you and therefore it is finding it difficult. So too also, what in this 1 hour I'm going to say is a very simple concept but profound. The Gita says very simple. Management guru says something simple. But that is a new rhythm. And we are used to the old rhythm of operating from our lower energies. We are not used to operate from higher energies. And therefore, friends, please get this. This is called mechanical. And therefore, if you see, have you seen one of the greatest obstacles for our excellence is fear. It's a Sufi character called Mullah Nasruddin was driving his car, and every time there was a honking of a lorry, Mullah used to shiver. He used to shiver. His friend observed 2 hours of travel. Every time the honking of a lorry, Mullah shivers. So at the end of the journey, his friend tells Mullah, why is that the honking of a lorry you shiver, not the honking of any other vehicle? Only the honking of a lorry. And Mullah said, I'm saying something very confidential. Keep it to yourself. Now it has reached up to here now. Anything confidential, keep to yourself. And he says, what? He says, my wife has been eloped by a lorry driver. So every time there's a honking of a lorry, I'm scared where the lorry driver will return the wife back to me. No, it's okay. It's okay. Thank you. You know, so much. Therefore, the Veda says, Bishasmat vatav pavate bishodeti surya. Even it appears the Surya, Chandra, everything seems to be operating from fear, fear, fear. And once, first important thing is, you should be a master of fear and not a victim of fear. And for that, a very beautiful concept is, you know, I'm a student, even though I'm a Swamiji, I'm a student of martial art. I'm learning a system of martial arts called Aikijujutsu. And therefore, I always like to learn some art. Because in Sandhya Vandana, you keep your hand in what is called Shika. This Anganyasa, Karanyasa we do. Right, in Anganyasa is one, here, here. And in Shikha, when you keep there, what is the mantra you utter? You are always a student of life. Means what? Always you must be learning, 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 learning. So every parent should be a learning parent, not a teaching parent. So often people become teaching parents, not learning parent. A good teaching parent is one who is a learning parent. Right? If you want to be in excellence, always learning. So therefore in Sandhya Vandana you do, in your Anganyasa, you do this called Shikha area, you utter, I'm always a student of life, you always learn. I have really taken that as a principle, and therefore even on Swamiji I learned a system of martial art, because Bhagavad Gita is taught in a conflict of, in a context of war. So when I started learning at the age of 48, 49 martial art, alright, and my martial art teacher, who is a black belt, say of 6th degree, he gave me now a book now. Right, Zen in martial art. And in the book there, now an incident happens, the author of the book, at the age, please digest this, and it'll be useful for our excellence here, as an example I'm giving. So this person, goes, now Mr. Joe, his name is, he goes to a famous martial art, Bruce Lee. I'm sure all of you have heard of Bruce Lee, right, Enter the Dragon and all that. Goes to the person, Bruce, is an actual story, and tells him, I want to learn martial art. And Bruce Lee says, I will teach you. After some time, right, he's nearly about 50 years old, he comes to Bruce Lee, his teacher, who is a legend in the art of martial art, and tells, I think I'm too old to learn martial art. I'm too old to learn martial art. And Bruce Lee says, why do you say that? He says, when you have to do some kicks, you have to take the leg and kick on the face. My leg is not going to the face. Then Bruce Lee says, if you can't hit the face, the chest is a broader target, he said. Look at the positive way of looking. The chest is a broad, because a good kick on a chest also is equally impactful. If your leg doesn't go to the face of your opponent. And to which Bruce, and Jim's Joe says, right, but I don't think I'm able to, I'm too old, I have my limitation in learning martial art. And Bruce Lee says, the strength of a warrior, and I'll say the strength of an executive, every executive is a warrior. He has to fight his competition. He has to go and still produce his result. And therefore, the strength of a warrior is, you have to learn to convert weaknesses into strengths. He said, convert weaknesses into strengths. And then Bruce Lee says, right, even I have limitations. And I was reading this, with the book, they were shocked. He says, I even have limitation. If you see Bruce Lee, his whole physique seems to be perfect. Alright? And then Bruce Lee tells him, see, nobody knows, and I'm telling you this. My right foot is 1 inch shorter than my left foot. My right foot, Bruce Lee says, right foot is shorter 1 inch than the left foot. And that's why Bruce Lee says, I take my stance, I put my right leg forward when I take the stance. Right? And therefore, right foot he takes forward to take a stance like this. And therefore, I believe in this one fact, it says, our capabilities are beyond our limitation. Can you repeat that, friends? Our capabilities are beyond our limitation. That was the belief, the Shraddha that he had. Right foot is one inch shorter, and therefore I have taken my disadvantage into a winning formula, and therefore he puts his right leg forward and on his toes and there and uses the stance. Still, Mr. Joe, some people, you know, they are never convinced. Some people believe, not getting convinced, you know. So this person again is not convinced, and then Bruce Lee says, my strength comes from this belief. My capabilities are beyond my limitations. And then he says, okay, I see your body language, you're not convinced. And Bruce Lee says, just see there, nobody knows, look at the limitation of my body. I am short-sighted. Bruce Lee says, I'm short-sighted. I was shocked when I came to read that. He's short-sighted. And you know what short-sighted? He's minus 10. No adbhuta in your face? Adbhuta means wonder, you know? Minus 10. And then he says, because that is why I do close encounters. I'm wearing contact lenses, close counters. He has devised a system of martial arts, right? Improvised a system of martial art. This is really putting 101%. Right? He has improvised this, where he has taken his limitations to his advantage, taken his weakness to his advantage. And therefore, he says, I take close stances there, and I believe, he says, my capability is beyond my limitation. Then this man continues there. He becomes a black belt. All right. Then, you know, and it was in Los Angeles, it was there. And then when he comes, it seems after he became a black belt, he comes to Mr. Joe's house, knocks at his door and says, again, I'm going, and I know where I'm going right now. From Los Angeles, I'm going, he says, to Hong Kong. All right. And I'm reminding you, our capabilities are beyond our limitation. And I'm reminding you, I'm telling you one thing, he says, now Hollywood has called me for a movie. He has called me for a movie. All right. See, I don't know how to speak English properly. And I'm the first Chinese who has been invited in Hollywood. And I'm reminding you, our capabilities are beyond our limitations. He's the first Chinese to be invited. Now, friends, to bring excellence and to put your 101% off, right, he is, please see, operating from this belief. This is operating from Paramatma. In Sanskrit, Paramatma means, Param means Utkrishtam, Shreshtam, right? Atma means self. You can operate from a Nikrishta Atma, from a lower self, of always afraid, upset, jealous, etc. You can operate from a higher stance when you are there. And when you operate from a higher stance, you will see one thing. Like the language has intrinsic conflicts when you say our capabilities are beyond our limitation. But still the language is powerful. Our capabilities in language, why if you see this, how can you be capabilities are beyond limitations? So too also, in simple arithmetics, 100% is 100%. But if you say 101%, you are going beyond the structure of language. And this is what in management you say, out of the box thinking. Don't you say out of the box thinking? In arithmetics is 100%, there is no such thing as 101%. That means go out of the box. Walt Disney was an unsuccessful cartoonist. I'm sure all of you know Walt Disney. He was an unsuccessful cartoonist. In the church of a garage, he was drawing cartoons. He was an unsuccessful cartoonist. Church of a garage is drawing cartoons there. All right. And it was the garage was infested with rats. Rats were going up and down. Walt Disney looked at the rat and he got his idea. Why can't I make the rat talk? And thus created Mickey Mouse. Rest is history. Fortune 500 companies there, Walt Disney is. Now just see, he went out of the box thinking. So therefore, friends, 100% is simple and arithmetic formula. 101 in a management jargon is going out of the box thinking. You can't imagine now, because sometimes we are a victim to our logic. Sometimes we are a victim to our logic and we don't know how to look at life beyond logic. That's why Sant Kabir says beautifully, Poti padi padi jagmuva pandit bayana koi, dai akar prem ka pade sa pandit hoi. We have got in this, had had par sabhi gaye, behat gayana koi, behat ka maidan mai, ramai kabira soi. There's some North Indians also here, right? You can understand Hindi. Right? Had had par sabhi gaye, everybody is living in boundaries. The boundaries of your mind, boundaries of your intellect. Behat gayana koi. You have not gone beyond your mind. And behat ka maidan mein, beyond the mind, ramai kabira soi. It appears kabir, very few people, right, are reveling, means don't get caught in the limitations of your own mind. Don't get caught in the limitation of your own logic and see the result of successful people. All of you have heard Beethoven? Yes, no. Beethoven, great master European composer of music. He was deaf when he composed his fifth orchid or something you call that? Fifth symphony. Right? He was deaf. It's mind-boggling. His super masterpiece. Right? He was deaf when he composed it. He was deaf. So I'm trying to convey this. Logically, you can't understand this. Logically, you can't understand. There is something beyond logic. And therefore, putting 101% is putting your totality in what you are doing. You have to learn to put your totality in what you are doing. And the totality is our capabilities are beyond limitations. When you come from that kind of beyond mind operation, amanaskaha in the Upanishad is called amanaskaha, going beyond the mind. And then you start looking at life there, not from your lower energies, from higher energies, life becomes beautiful. Right, excellence, please understand, involves two dimensions. The dimensions of being how an outer winner in life, the dimensions of being an inner winner in life. Two winners you have to be in life. Outer winner gives you success. Inner winner gives you satisfaction. If you want to bring excellence, right, you have to work on both the paradigms on how to bring success and satisfaction in your life. If you don't do that, only your success is going to be unfulfilling. Right, therefore, very successful people like Dale Carnegie committed suicide at the end of his life. Elvis Presley, who is still worshipped in the field of music, and even now in America, people go and put all flowers in his graveyard. He was the most frustrated man at the end of his life. So therefore, don't be right caught up in this illusion that success is the be-all and end-all of life. I'm intentionally saying the corporate world. So therefore, when you bring excellence, it needs a little shift. That's all it needs. Outer world, success. Inner world, satisfaction. See, I have a center in Switzerland. I go every year to Switzerland, to my center, to my students there, and think, Switzerland is the most beautiful place, especially Zurich. I have a center in Zurich. Zurich is the most beautiful place in the world. Right? The winters are magical. The summer is beautiful. It's a honeymoon center of the world. And every time I go take a workshop, there'll always be somebody depressed. And depression is one issue I have to handle. And it is not like a life of California. It is a little more peaceful life. The places Zurich and Vancouver are supposed to be the two most beautiful cities for family people to live in the world. Zurich and Vancouver. Why? Because every flat in Zurich has to have compulsory a nuclear basement. Just not ordinary basement. If you have five flats, residential flats, you should have residential nuclear basement, some storage, if there's a nuclear leak, to go there. Such a wonderful city like Zurich, I go every year. Every time there's somebody who's in depression, then I always tell them, you are all kings and queens. I tell them, you are kings and queens. And I'm saying the same to the group here. All of you are kings and queens. Yes or no? Right, you may say, Swamiji, I know my bandwala. In Telugu, if you say, "Na bandwaram tel Swamiji," right? If you know, I know what is my this one, kings and queens. I'll say honestly, even there, I started giving this example. I'm saying it here. All of you are kings and queens. Why? Because what a king and a queen did not have 100 years back, you and I have. Yes or no? A king and a queen did not have a mobile. You and I have. Yes, no? All of you say, "Wow!" Say, "Wow!" Right, 100 years back, a king and a queen did not have a computer. You and I have. Say, wow. 100 years back, king and a queen did not have a washing machine. You and I have. So what a king and a queen did not have 100 years back, you and I have. So we are richer than kings and queens. Why is that? But even though you are laughing deep within, you're pretty Swamiji. King and king, easy to say. But still, please see, even though you and I are kings and queens, we don't experience ourselves as a king and a queen. Why? Even though I'm telling you to say, wow, you'll say, what, wow? My junior is my boss now. Avanga paatha Uttar Pradesh la ella empty a irukudhu. All this, you say this, even though you're king and queen, why don't we experience the richness of a king and a queen? You know why? Because the neighbor also has a mobile. The neighbor also has a washing machine. The neighbor also has something else. And therefore, we don't experience. So you see now, because the neighbor has a mobile, you have a mobile. Enough periya vishayam idu. You say this, so therefore, there is a deleting mechanism which comes and deletes the richness of who you are. You unnecessarily compare and delete. Healthy comparison is good. Unhealthy compare, you compare. And therefore, God has given us beautiful programming. When your mind has this virus of negative comparing, it deletes the richness of who you are. In your computer, if you have programmed it very well and there's a virus, It knocks off your great program, isn't it? So what do? You install antivirus. So too also God's software, wonderful. We have to say wow to life. To be happy, you simply have to say wow to life. But we can't experience this because your mind comes and compares. The neighbor's bank balance is better. Alright, and therefore you delete the richness you are. Therefore satisfaction we are not able to experience in life. We are not able to experience satisfaction because this virus is coming. The antivirus is jnana and bhakti. Even in the corporate world, I'm saying the spiritual input is there. That's why when you do Sandhyavandana, when you do even puja sankalpa, it's a jnana bhakti vairagya siddhyartam aham idam pujam karishe. To increase jnana, knowledge, bhakti, devotion, vairagya, you should get detached to your jivatma, lower way. Right? Aham idam pujam karishe. I do this. Same concept. Increase your knowledge of how to enhance excellence. Increase your devotion and then you will say, right, wow to life. All of you say wow?
Wow.
Very few of us say, what is wow to say? Right? You can't say wow. That's why one of the dissatisfactions you get, and in excellence, you have to say wow, then you can perform better. Like a martial artist, he faces enemy stronger than him, still he says, kia! He brings that energy out. In army, it is said, right, if you want to be a colonel, walk like a colonel, even though your opponent, he appears tougher than you, you have to bring your urja, your higher energy in the forefront. And so to excellence, when I say outer and inner, success and satisfaction, the satisfaction is you have to bring wow. Therefore, in the Navarasas, there are 9 rasas in the Indian culture. And one of the rasa is Hasya Adbhuta, Shringara Veera Karuna Bayanaka Raudra Bibatsa and Shanta. Adbhuta and wonder. What a wonderful world. What a wonderful world. When you have wonder and your boss is banging you with wonderment, you will see how his mustache goes up and down, up and down. You will count the cavity of his teeth and pray for his wife. In spite of bulldozing, he has survived. See, when you have adbhuta, nothing happens. For some people, there's no adbhuta. No wonderment. Ah. 5-star, you say, ah. For some people, they look at Aishwarya Roy and a buffalo, both are same for them. Yes, ma, dono mein fark hi nahi. Ah. I have seen some people, no wonderment, no criticism, please. A Punjabi comes to Chennai and he was shocked to see in Chennai, shairi sessions were going on. In Nardagan Sabha, 1,000 people with andhautis and namum, the shairi person was saying a shairi. Shairi means Hindi, Urdu, couplets. And this Punjabi was shocked. Are Madrasi log abhi Hindi seekh rahe? Anand ki baat hai, ullas ki baat hai? Because Madrasis were always against Hindi. Are bahut kush se andar ghus gaya. Nardagan Sabha, he entered the Nardagan Sabha. And the Madrasi with the dhoti, namum, and juttu, he is saying a shairi. And what is a shairi? Right, dabba pe dabba. Means one dabba, or dabba mele inor dabba anete. Avlada. Hey, everybody, wow, 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 wow. This Punjabi got confused. What type of shairi? Dabba pe dabba, iski wow, wow ki kya baat hai? Chuma, or dabba mele inor dabba, inna periya. What is a big thing about it? And then this man says, Amidi, Amidi, calm down, calm down. Then he says, Dabba pe dabba, us pe dabba. And that too, he does the alap, dabba. And all Madrasi with the dhotis are jumping on the chairs. The Punjabi got utterly confused. Generally, he is confused, but here he got more confused. He got more confused. 15 minute ekhi alap hai. 15 minutes to ore alap hai. Dabba me pair, dabba pe dabba, or dabba mele, or dabba, or mele dabba. And everybody, wah, 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 this fellow Punjabi BP was coming up. Then he pulls the man next to him and says, kya shari hai? Na yenna piriya shari hai? What kya shari hai? And the Madrasi says, chodo yaar shari. Forget about the shari. Then what is this wah, 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 wah? Arre, dekho kya balance hai, dekho na dabba pe dabba. And the balance parpa, or dabba mele dabba, yenna adbhutama irukudhu. See, if you have Adbhuta Rasa, you will create your own Disneyland of joy. I'm trying to convey. When you don't have Adbhuta, nothing, sun rises, every day it rises. Time la difference illa parappa. When somebody sun rises, he does his Gayatri Mantra. So I'm saying for excellence, very, very important is you have. So in the Indian model, we say three lehris. In the Bhagavad, the life of Lord Krishna, we say three. All right, in the corporate world, I put in my life workshops, when you do, I literally see people will be dancing at the end of the workshops I do, because Lord Krishna's three energies in the Bhagavad are Ananda Lahari. All of you say that? Prema Lahari. Saundarya Lahari. In the Bhagavad, in the life of Lord Krishna, these three energies, I say, in the corporate world, also is very important to bring excellence in this. One is Ananda Lahari. Ananda Lahari means, Lahari means waves. Ananda means joy. Whatever you do, Lord Krishna says, bring out joy. Anandam brahmeti vyajanat anandat eva kalvimani bhutani jayante yena jatani jivanti. So the Veda says, God is nothing but Ananda. Ananda means joy. Whatever you do out of joy. Whatever you do out of joy. You're taking a bath out of joy, walking out of joy, then your work becomes fun. You don't have to work for fun. For a lot of people, work for fun. Therefore, ganja, hashish, cocaine, crack, all these type of drugs, because they don't know. If you practice Ananda Lahari, right? Now, I don't talk for happiness. Talking itself is happiness. I don't work for happiness. Working itself is happiness. A beautiful Bhagavad concept. Right now I'm talking, not for happiness. Talking itself is happiness. It's wonderful God has given me a voice to talk. It's wonderful He has given me a brain to talk. It's wonderful He has given this wonderful body where tremendous engineering work is there. I can move. What a great miracle this body is. So therefore, I'm so wonderful. There are about 150 to 170 people listening. Right? How to bring a spiritual paradigm in the field of management. Right? When you have that, then work itself is joy. Or else what happens? You will work for joy. And most of the people, have you seen marriages also? Problem is you get married for happiness. Very few people get married out of happiness. So you get married for happiness. One is a beggar getting married to another beggar. When two beggars meet for marriage, beggary increases. All of that. That's why Sharma and Varma was in the boat. Sharma fell down from the boat. Both of them did not know swimming. Sharma fell down. So Varma said, Sharma, give me your hand. And Sharma is not giving his hand. Are yena pa idu? Give me your hand, you're drowning. He's not giving. Then Varma realizes, Sharma has been such a conjuice. He has never given in his life anything. So give me your life and the language of Puriyada. Give me your hand means he has never given, no. So he changes vocabulary and says, hey Sharma, take my hand. Then Sharma gives out his hand. He gives not the best who gives the most, but he gives the most who gives the best. If I cannot give bountiful, yet I will give freely. And what I lack in my hand, I'll supply it in my heart. In my book which I've written, I've given this. He gives not the best who gives the most, but he gives the most who gives the best. So therefore, please see, first thing to excellence to bring in, right? Both your self-satisfaction and outer winner also will be out of joy. Everything out of joy. Anything you do out of joy. Somebody is banging you, say it's full of joy he's banging. Say it. Don't tell him loudly, he'll bang more. This is the practice. And you look at Lord Krishna's life. Before he was born, he had a problem. During his birth, he has a problem. And throughout his life, he has always been smiling, smiling, smiling. And in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Prasanna chetasa yi ajuhu buddhihi pariyavatishtati. Be cheerful and fight, O Arjuna, he says. He is saying, Lord Krishna tells Arjuna, be cheerful and fight. So that means what? Come from Ananda Lahari. Whatever out of joy. Take your bath out of joy, eat your food out of joy, work out of the joy. You do out of joy, there is a satisfaction which comes. Right? Many problems in a corporate world is interpersonal relationships. Anything for the mud, itere. Because some people have a crab psychology, somebody going up, you pull the person down. Biggest management, any corporate world, interpersonal relationship, you feel jealous of that person, somebody, oh, he, if a person is successful, instead of learning his success, you start telling something about it. In all this, I tell, please see important thing. And husband-wife relationship also, problem is interpersonal relationship. All this, what is so great message the Gita can offer, the Bhagavad can offer, learn the knack of enjoying. But start off with small things. You're going to the bathroom, simply say, wow. Right? There's one way of saying, wow. Taking a bath, wow. Eyes are winking, wow. Not winking at somebody, general winking, wow. So everything you say, wow, wow. Then, you know, bigger challenges, you'll be able to take it. Now, I was giving a series of discourses on Bhagavad Gita and Baroda. And one person in Gujarat, in Baroda, one person came to me, Swamiji, too much of problem, too much of problem. He says, what is the problem? You're not married, you can give a discourse, Swamiji. Get married to my wife, then you will see how you can be happy. You know, I'm a very jolly, very free person. For me, Lord Krishna is the role model. And Lord Krishna has always been, if you see, so free, so jolly. Right? So the first my role model. And I said, and with my students, I'm very jolly there. I said, what's your problem? He said, see, Swamiji, I'm a businessman. I come home little late. When I come home little late, my wife starts nagging. And when she starts nagging, my BP goes up. And day before yesterday, I got so angry, I threw the cup of tea and fell on the TV and the TV broke. I thought my wife will be unhappy, but I found her to be happy. Because she saw me out of control, that means she is in control. It's a very problem. So he says, Swamiji, I'm scared if this nagging continues where my VCR will break. To save the VCR, will you give me a mantra, he's saying. Not to save the relationship, to save the VCR. All right, I told him, seer, you have to create a balance between work and home. You're not only wedded to marriage, you're wedded to your wife also. So I told him, you have to learn to manage your temper. Right? And I gave him so many breathing techniques. I gave him so many techniques how to give quality time to your wife, not quantity time. What is meant by quality time? In my life workshops, I tell, what is meant by really quality time? Your wife does not need quantity time. Too much means she'll get suffocated being with you. They also need intervals, you know. Spaces, so therefore quality time, what is quality time, blah, 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 all that I gave technique, and finally, this Bhagavad technique called Ananda Lehri. What does it say? In spite of it, you come late, and your wife nags, simply enjoy the nagging. Avladha. Simple. Simply enjoy. He says, Yepri Swamji, how in Hindi he says, Kaisa ho sakta hai, how to enjoy the nagging? Simply enjoy, I said. But how? That's the technique in Bhagavad. I said, no, I have to give an example to him. Are, do you take alcohol? I asked him. He said, yes, I take alcohol. When you take alcohol, it is what? Gulab jamun taste? Rasgulla taste? It's bitter, no? Yes, no? Huh? Yes, bitter. But then, even though it is bitter, you go on taking it, taking it, taking it. Then you will enjoy that bitterness. Right? So too, your wife's nagging initially will be like alcohol. But in the level, on the level, right? So too, your wife's nagging initially will be like alcohol. But you enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. You'll get a kick out of alcohol. That's why do you get married? To get a kick, no, I said. A lot of Gujaratis are very devotional people. If all the states, I find Gujarati, very devotion. And especially Guru, they have a lot of devotion. He says, and with a pinch of salt, he went away. After 1 week, he comes with a binaka smile. And says, Swamiji, it worked, Swamiji. And I myself got confused how it worked. Because I'm a motivator. Right? And when he said, worked, I also laughed. And I said, I'm laughing not because of you, because in Times magazine, I read a cartoon, husband comes, the wife says, where have you been? The husband says to the guru, what did the guru do? He gave me a mantra. What is the mantra? He told me not to tell the mantra to anybody, especially you. And this wife said, 27 years I'm married. This guru who came yesterday, now you better make your decision-making skills. You want the mantra or you want me? He went on chanting the mantra mentally. My guru said not to tell the mantra. She packs all her luggage, goes to the door. Mantra or me? Right, he went on mentally chanting. She walks out of the house. This man turns and says, mantra works. So when he says it works, you know, I laugh. When he says works, I laugh. Not because of that. I said because of the cartoon I read. That's why when your boss bangs you, it may not be because of you. Some problem he must be having through. Wife problem, Stephanie problem, I don't know what problem. So therefore, just you have to be sensitive to all this. You have to see life in its totality. Don't see life in linearly. And he laughed. And then I said, then what happened? I asked him. He says, Swamiji, see, you told me, enjoy the Ananda Lahiri. I came, I practiced everything. I came home late and then my wife started nagging. And the BP was going up. I remembered your mantra. What is my mantra? Ananda Lahiri, enjoy. I folded my hands and I said, let me enjoy. Swamiji, she was serving coffee, right? And she was cursing the astrologer who set the marriage, the parents of the astrologer and producing the astrologer. All right, all this, Swamiji. But the first time I realized when I came from Ananda Lahiri, how beautifully my wife nags. Because in the nagging, so many communication skills are there. There is pace, pause, pitch, punctuation, voice modulation, open statement, close statement, funnel technique, multiple closes, disarming technique, preemptive strike. All this is the communication skills. All right? And therefore, all this are there. And I have gone through communication workshops. The leader has improved. I have remained. Kupaswami. And this wife, you know, has improved so much. And then I realized, Swamiji, what? I said, hey, why is my wife nagging me? Because she loves me. Right? Why can't I see the love that she wants me? I'm so lucky my wife loves me in spite of options available. Life is about options only. Right? Because divorce is also an option as marriage. And therefore, and I realize she's loving me, because she loves me, she's nagging, and therefore she wants me more. I said, why should I use logic? Simply, I got up, Swamiji, I hugged and became grateful to God. All right, I just hugged her. She started crying, I started crying. The problem was not solved, it got dissolved. Avladha ore shot. After 7 years, he goes to, Gujarat. Right, I went after 7 years and says, Patel Saab, su kabar che? He said, majame che. I said, beso, I said, sit down. Right, how is your relationship is going on? He said, nagging continues, my enjoyment continues. Please understand, your difficulties will continue, your ability to enjoy life should continue. Go in the field of music, a starter will be struggling in music. The guru will be struggling in his level and his guru will be struggling every level. Every person will be struggling in their level. You have to make your struggles sacred. You have to just make your struggles sacred. Everybody will be struggling in every field. So therefore, if you have learned what the Bhagavad says, Ananda Lahiri. Lahiri means waves, Ananda, joy. Once you start bringing Ananda Lahiri in whatever you are doing, there will be satisfaction. That is excellence. Then the satisfaction should not stop only at satisfaction. It should start at success also. Once you are satisfied, you are full, there is a passion, there is utsaha in you. Right? Once there is utsaha in you, Lord Shiva in the Shiva Sutra says, utsaha creates the utsava. It becomes a utsava. It becomes a festival. When it becomes a festival, you will be above a problem and not a victim to a problem. Because in handling success in life, understand you are bound to have problems in life. Yes or no? Yes, sir. What time am I supposed to end? I'm sorry, I'm asking this. What? The talk started at 3:10, okay? Okay, I'll have another 10 minutes. Then I'll give you some question answers, okay? See, so long you're living, you're bound to have problems. This should be very clear. In the area of success, you're going to have problems. When you are a problem, you either are a victim to a problem Are you a master of the problem? Is very important. Alright, what happens to a lot of people? They become a victim to a problem, they have a problem. In the area of success, you should never be a victim to the problem. You should be a master to the problem. Please, in my book, Oh Mind Relax, Please, Oh Life Relax, Please, I have given this example. Right, there's an 8 years, 7 years old boy, true story, 7 years old boy, true story now, right, he's a black American boy, he's still living, as a man he's living now, this story that in my book I've given this, black American boy, he is a lover of football, you know, American football is not soccer, you know, they have to wear helmets, it's like rugby, you know, it's a very tough and a violent game it is, unlike a soccer. In India, we say football for that. But that is called, in America, they call that football there. Right? No, this boy, he's a lover of American football. He waits up to the gate. He comes from a broken family. And wait, the gatekeeper, out of compassion, allowed him. Okay, go inside. And this man goes and meets Mr. Brown, who is one of the greatest American football players at that point of time. He goes and touches him at the break time, right, and says, I'm a great fan of yours. Please listen carefully. He says, great boy. Again, he touches him and says, I'm following all your matches. He says, great boy. Brown says, great boy. Again, he touches him. I'm keeping a track of all your records. He says, great boy. Again, he touches him and says, I'm going to break every record of yours. And then he stops.